wanted to cosplay Kokomi, but her canon outfit is a whole hassle to put on, so I just wore her wig with the school uniform. I completely forgot to record this part, but I carpooled my friend who was cosplaying Mafuyu from Project Sekai.
Whoa!
We decided to go to the Anime Impulse side of the convention first, and this booth selling blind boxes immediately got our attention. But almost immediately afterward, we decided to go visit the food street because we were hungry. There were a lot of stalls, but we settled for this corn dog place. I chose this unicorn one that's supposed to have rainbow mozzarella in it. We also got these chicken skewers, which tasted alright. I mean, they weren't too special, and they only had like one piece of mochi on them, which was kind of lame. By this time, I had already split up with my friends, and I kind of just went solo from this point onward. I was heading back to Anime Impulse, but I only hung out there for like 15 minutes because the K-pop random dance play was starting. I was sweating like crazy after the RPD, and Yakult was giving out free samples, so I obviously had to take one. My mom picked me up from the con around 4 p.m, so I went home and took a shower first, then I went to go eat dinner at a Chinese restaurant with my family and my friend's family. Afterward, we went to Sunrise Tea Studio because they were having a collaboration with Honkai Star Rail and my friend wanted to check it out. Here's a drink I got. It ended up being a bit too sweet for my liking, but still tasted pretty good. Here's the outfit for day 2 of the convention. I'm cosplaying Bocchi from Bocchi the Rock with the bunny hat. Honestly, I was feeling kind of self-conscious today because I didn't really like how I did my makeup. We went to Anime Impulse first and bought some stuff in the artist alley and vendor hall. Around 1 p.m, we went to the food street for lunch. I got the Hot Cheetos corn dog this time, and honestly, I still like the unicorn one more because this one didn't have cheese in it, and something about cheese in a corn dog just hits different. After the corn dogs, we wanted to get some drinks, so we went to this fruit drink stall selling these fancy cups that we had seen people carrying around. The cups were cute, but the drinks ended up being really expensive, but I'll give them a pass because it's expensive to sell at a con in the first place. And we also got these tteokbokki and sausage skewers, and they were honestly pretty good. After lunch, we walked around K Playfest for a bit, which I didn't record, and I went to the RPD again, and my friend was able to record a few clips of me dancing this time. But it was super crowded, even more crowded than yesterday. I literally just stopped recording after that because I was so tired, but we went back to Anime Impulse and walked around for a bit, and we decided to get in line to play DDR, and surprisingly, a lot of people came up to us and asked us to take photos with them, which was really cool. So I came back from the convention and I ate dinner and I took a shower. But anyways, I'm gonna do a little merch haul of everything I got over the last 2 days. So I'll just start with the stuff I got on day one. I think the first thing I got was this Chikawa blind box. It's like a little like plastic keychain thingy. So I got this one. Originally I actually got this one, but my friend also got one of these boxes and we wanted to trade, so I traded with her and I got this one. Let me just like unwrap it. I think the next thing I got was this Pochita sticker. It says Hello Evrinyan. I actually didn't buy this. I took a picture with the Kobeni cosplayer and she gave me this, so that's really cool. And like, I also got this Aster print. I also didn't buy this. A friend gave me this. She was handing out like freebies, so yeah, that's cool. And then I bought these New Jeans stickers at K Playcon. Yeah. They're so cute. I also saw like Espo ones, and I'm like debating or getting the New Jeans ones or Espo ones, but in the end I chose New Jeans. I don't really know what I'm gonna use them for because they're really cute and I'm kind of like scared to use them in case I accidentally waste them or something. But yeah. So I got these two photo cards. These two people running this like photo card gotcha thing. These are like unofficial photo cards. They had like this huge cardboard box and they had a sign that said like $1 photo card gotcha. So I paid $2 and like pulled twice. The box was separated into two sizes, like a boy group one and a girl group one. I obviously just did the girl group one because I don't know any boy groups honestly. So first I got this NMIX one. I honestly don't know who this is because I don't stan NMIX. If you know who it is, feel free to just like tell me in the comments. And the second one I got was this Inche one from Le Sserafim. So yeah. I honestly don't really care that they're like unofficial photo cards. I don't really like care about photo card collecting and everything. And then I'm gonna show my haul from the second day, which is today. And I think the first thing I got was this pin. I think I relate to this statement, so I got this pin. After that, I was trying to get like more prints to put up in my room, but in the end, I kind of ended up just getting a bunch of other random stuff. I did end up getting prints. After the girl boss pin, I got this otter keychain. Actually, my friend paid for me because she wanted to get like matching ones. So yeah, we got a set of these little otter keychains. They're so cute. And yeah, I actually got a print. This is a Link Click print. It looks so cool. I really like the holographic thingy detailing. Link Click is so good. If you haven't watched Link Click, you have to watch it. And then I saw this artist selling Twisted Wonderland stuff, and they had like this, like, not really a deal, but like they had like a promotion sort of, that if you buy $25 worth of Twisted Wonderland merch, you could get a free like photo card,
K-pop music club photo card. And like, I was asking if they could sell the photo card separately, and they said no. So I ended up getting $25 worth of Twisted Wonderland merch. I got this Pop Music Club standee. Let me just like open it. Actually, I got more than $25 worth, but yeah. It's so cute. I really like this. But yeah, I got that, and I also got this like Twisted Wonderland washi tape thingy. I really like the designs on this. It's like, let me just like show some of them. How do I take it out? Oh, okay. I don't want to like open it yet, but I can show some of the designs. It's so cool. It's like a stamp washi tape. But yeah, it has like a lot of the characters. They even have the teachers, which is really cool. And the ghosts. Oops. Okay. Well, yeah, I got that. And originally they said like the photo card that you would get would be randomized, but they asked me which one I wanted, and I said Lilia. I guess they knew I was just like aiming for the photo card, so they just asked me which one I wanted, which is pretty cool. And I also got this large venti print. I think it's really pretty. And I wanted more like blue color scheme prints for my wall, because I kind of have like a pink section going on and like a green section, like green and yellow. And like the blue side is kind of like empty, so I wanted to get more prints. So yeah, I got this like the Blink Clip one, which is mostly blue, and I got the venti one. And then last but not least, I have this like little gacha capsule. I didn't originally buy this, but my friend was like doing the gacha, and she ended up getting a duplicate, so she ended up giving it to me. Let me just like open it. There we go. This is Kagamina Rin. So eepy. That's the end of my haul. Thank you guys for watching.